A high GMAT score is the single most critical component of your MBA application. The decision tracker on GMAT Club shows that applicants who scored 760 and above are approximately 4 times more likely to be admitted to top business schools compared to applicants who scored less than 700. And that's not all. A 740 scorer on an average wins a scholarship of a massive $40,000. So scoring high on the GMAT not only increases your chances of getting an admit from a top B school, but it also paves the way for you getting a substantial scholarship. Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. Today we are going to share with you the 5 key steps to scoring a 700 plus on the GMAT. Before you unlock this recipe to success, please subscribe to our channel for more such videos. You will see content on GMAT preparation, MBA admissions, MBA scholarships and career transformation. Okay, so without any further ado, let's get to the 5 steps. The first step is planning. To plan efficiently for your GMAT, you need to know 3 things. What is the GMAT about? What are your strengths and weaknesses? How much time and effort you need to reach 700 plus? Thousands of GMAT test takers fail to prepare the right way because they don't fundamentally understand how the GMAT works. It is critical to understand what the GMAT is, what its different sections are, what it tests, how it is scored, and much more. You can watch our video where we cover everything you need to know about the test. Just click on the top right-hand corner. Once you understand what the GMAT is about, you need to analyze your strengths and weaknesses. Are you better at quant or verbal? Moreover, out of the 5 subsections, which ones are you good at and where do you lack? To know this, you can either take the GMAT test and get your enhanced score report or the ESR, all of which will cost you approximately $300. Or you can take a free Sigma X mock that provides in-depth insights about your strengths and weaknesses. Once you know what your weaknesses are, you can then focus your time and effort on strengthening those areas. But how do you know how much time and effort to put in? For that, you should have a comprehensive study plan. Make sure that your study plan answers these 3 questions. How will you reach your target GMAT score? How much time you need to put in? And where do you need to put in this time? Take a look at our video on how to create a GMAT study plan. Just click on the top right-hand corner. Once you're done with the planning stage, the next step is to learn concepts and how to apply those concepts. 700 plus scorers always credit their success to strong conceptual foundations. Without a strong grasp on concepts, test takers often select a wrong choice, spend too much time solving a question, or are forced to just skip the question. Moving on to step 3. Around 80% of your success on the GMAT depends on practicing the right kind of questions. Once you're done building a solid foundation and applying those concepts on easy questions, it is important to test those skills by practicing medium and hard level GMAT-like questions. You also want to keep an eye on the timer and ensure that you're not taking more than 2 minutes to solve each question. Remember, GMAT is a timed adaptive test. So to get a 700 plus score, you need to solve medium and hard level questions correctly within the allotted time. Once you've practiced GMAT-like questions and improved upon your timing, you can simulate exam conditions by taking mock tests. Please take an official GMAT mock test or a Sigma X mock test, as the scoring on these tests is the most representative of the scoring on the actual GMAT. After taking the mock test, analyze your performance by identifying your weak areas and assessing any timing issues. The idea is to take this feedback, spend time working on it, and then take another mock test to confirm that you have fixed the issues. At last, it's time for the final step to score 700 plus on the GMAT. Many students do well on the mock tests, but on test day, they struggle to keep their composure and so fail to achieve their target GMAT scores. It is important to learn and practice test day strategies to ensure that you can deal with all that the GMAT can throw at you. We cover these testing strategies to help overcome performance issues. You can access this by clicking on the top right-hand corner of the video. So folks, this is how you can achieve a 700 plus on the GMAT in 5 key steps. But scoring 700 plus also requires a top prep resource. Looking for the best GMAT preparation resources can be tricky and time consuming. So we are offering a limited time free trial with access to 10 plus hours of video lessons, 400 plus practice questions, 7 live sessions and 1 Sigma X mock test. Link is in the description. Thank you for watching this video and press on that bell icon to never miss an update from us. Stay safe and happy learning.